Hey guys, in this video I'm going to be going over how to read nutrition labels. So I'm going to be using the 5-1 delights as my reference. I'm going to put the calories just right here. The first thing we want to look at is the serving size. So this can be a little bit misleading. We're using an easy product that just has one pouch or 25 grams. But if you got something like cereal that says one cup or 40 grams, you might want to weigh it out just to make sure you're getting an accurate amount of calories per serving size. After that, we look at the calories, which is what most people just look at, but the calories don't tell the full story. So in this product, we are working with 90 calories. And to the right, we have our percent daily value, which is based off a 2000 calorie diet. After the calories, we got our fats. So this product has 3 grams of fat, or 4% of our daily value. Below that, we got our saturated and trans fats. Trans fats you want to avoid as much as possible. We get 7% of our daily value there. Below that, we have our cholesterol, which there's 0 milligrams of cholesterol in this. Cholesterol is something you want to watch out for. Below that, we have sodium. So there's 80 milligrams or 3% of our daily value of sodium in this. Sodium is something you want to watch because sodium is in a lot of foods in large amounts. For some people, you want to limit the amount of sodium that you're getting in your diet, so you want to keep an eye on that. Below that, we have our carbohydrates. So this is 18 grams or 6% of our daily value. And carbohydrates are pretty broad. So below that, we see here we got fiber, which is sitting at 5 grams or 20% of our daily value of fiber. And then even lower, we have our sugar, which is 8 grams. Sugar is one of the macronutrients we want to avoid as much as possible and opt for more of our slower digesting carbohydrates. So sugar is one of those things that you want to look out for when you're reading a nutrition label. Below that, we have our protein, which is sitting at 1 gram. So that's our macronutrients. You got 3 grams of fat, 18 grams of carb, 1 gram of protein, meaning this food is dense in carbohydrates. This can be a little bit misleading. If you have a food that has 8 grams of fat and 10 grams of protein, you might think that this is a high protein food. In actuality, it is higher in fats than it is in protein. This is due to fats having 9 calories per gram and carbs and protein both having 4 calories per gram. So that's something you gotta watch out for. Below the macronutrients, we have our micronutrients. This is a processed good, so it's very low in its micronutrients with no vitamin A, C, or calcium and 2% of our daily value of iron. And then below this, we have the ingredients. So this is made with enriched wheat flour, chicory root extract, semi-sweet chocolate chips, icing sugar, sugarcane fiber, fructose, sugar. And as you can see, there's a lot of sugar in this. It is branded as a fiber food and there is fiber in it, but it also is higher in sugar than it is in fiber. Even lower on the ingredient list, it says it contains wheat, eggs, soy, and milk, and may contain peanut ingredients. So this is something else you gotta look out for if you have any type of food allergies. It's gonna be listed there on the bottom of the ingredients. So a quick recap, we have our calories up at the top, the fat below that. Some nutrition labels might have calories from fat to help further clarify the amount of calories that you're getting from the fats. On the middle of this, we have our carbohydrates and our fiber and our sugars. You want to look at this to make sure that you're getting higher amounts of fiber, less sugar. And then at the bottom, we have our protein. So for most people, you want to prioritize your protein intake because it's a little bit more difficult to get in than carbohydrates or fats. Whenever I look at a nutrition label, I'm looking at the calories, the fats, carbs, and protein, but I place a lot of value on the protein in the product. Overall, nutrition labels are fairly easy to read. You just have to make sure that you're looking through and understanding the information that's on it. Checking the ingredients is also a good idea. The less ingredients in a product, the less processed it probably is. So that is something to look out for. The percent daily value is based off of a 2000 calorie diet, and this boils down into 65 grams of fat, 20 grams of saturated fat, under 300 milligrams of cholesterol, 2400 milligrams of sodium, 300 grams of carbs, 25 grams of fat, no daily value for sugar, no daily value for protein either. It used to be 50, but protein requirements are different from person to person. Vitamin C being at least 60 milligrams, calcium being at least 1100 milligrams, and iron being at least 14 milligrams. This is all based off of the Canada's Food Guide. I hope this video was useful in understanding how to read nutrition labels. Hit that subscribe button below for more content like this. and I'll see you guys next time.